Tilcon New York, how you doing? That's the great Henry Mancini, the theme from the Pink Panther, originally played by Peter Sellers, played later on by Steve Martin. All right. How's everybody doing? Hopefully you've had a good week and a good weekend. We've had some beautiful fall weather. We're going to try to take this off without pulling a muscle. Okay. And how about that? We put that on here. So, all right. So I'm entertaining Mrs. Cacavalli at the moment. Okay. Well, first of all, thanks for attending. Okay, so this week we're going to talk about, investigating. So you can see the lead in with the Pink Panther and Professor or Inspector Clouseau. My wife says I have a terrible French accent, so no, I'm not going to even try it. So a couple things. You know, we've been conducting, we've probably done about 30, 35 events learning so far this year. And that's really kind of getting down to the meat of an incident for us. So some of the things that kind of build on that, you know, we have hazard recognitions, and you guys have been doing a great job at that. I know I sound like a broken record, but I sound like a good broken record. The risk assessments, and then a near miss report. So these three are positive aspects that will lead us to not having incidents or reducing the amount of incidents that we have or the severity of them. But there's a couple things that kind of lead into some more severe cases. First aid cases, I call them kissing a Band-Aid, but these are where you can take care of it with a first aid kit. Sometimes we send somebody out for medical attention and the doctor just treats it as such. Environmental spills or environmental events, you know, we have a release, we have some kind of spill to the ground. Those are type of incidents that could be significant. Transportation events, PVIs, yellow irons, registered vehicles. Those are the type of things that could be, somewhat on a dangerous side, depending on the incident itself. And then property damage. We damage a lot of a good part of the property. That's also another thing that could lead to some kind of serious event. And then finally, the other two are process upsets. And this is when we have a breakdown in the process, fire, explosion. Those type of events, a catastrophic failure of one of our pieces of equipment, the major belt breaks and spews rocks and material all over the place. Those are the type of things we call process events. And then security breaches. We had an IT security breach. Somebody got into our networks. Somebody broke into our facilities and stole computers or stole equipment from us. Broke in and ran off of one of our big pieces of equipment. We had a piece of construction equipment stolen in 2019 season. So those are the type of things we're talking about, security breaches. So all of these kind of leads to events learnings. So let's talk about what we need what's the information that we really need? So when we're talking about an incident, we just want the facts. Anybody remember the old show, Dragnet? Thank you, Mrs. Cacavalli. Dragnet, you know, they had two versions of it. They had the old version back in the 60s, 70s, and then they did a newer version of it. But Dragnet had the facts, ma'am, just the facts. You know, when Sergeant Friday used to go out and you know, interview folks. So that's all we're looking for. So we're looking at the who, the what, the where, the when, and the why, and all of this kind of equates to how the incident happened. So when we're taking a look at all that, we're doing these five W's and an H. So what we ask, an incident occurs, okay? The first thing for everybody is to make sure they notify their supervisor. That's really important. Notify your supervisor so we can start actions to be taken with regards to if we need emergency actions, if we have to call 911, we don't always, but if we had to call 911 to come in, that's important that we get that going right away. We make sure that we secure the scene, making sure we don't, you know, move any evidence, if you will. We identify if there was any witnesses that saw what happened that could give us, you know, background information, you know, whether they saw stuff that happened prior to the incident or stuff that happened, you know, right after the incident. You know, we want to gather evidence, photos, tools that we use, personal protective equipment that we use. I mean, that's important for us to gather all that evidence to make sure that we do a good job, you know, taking a look at the investigation. We conduct interviews. We want to make sure we talk to everybody that was involved. That way here, we just get the facts from everybody. And then we ask our supervisors to submit initial report. So this all can happen usually right on the shift that the incident occurs. Probably, I'm telling you as a safety professional, probably 80 to 90% of our incidents that happen can be fully investigated, you know, during the shift itself. It can be happened right by the folks that the incident happened, and we can rectify and remedy the situation right there. But when things get to the next level, okay, we go into a deeper dive. And that's when we start to do the events learning. So what we'll do sometimes is we'll speak with other departments, we'll speak with other teams, other individuals, somebody that might be doing the job at a different site. Guys and gals in our organization may have 30 years experience and say, hey, we've been doing it like this for a long time. You know, maybe some of our sister companies have had some of these events happen. You know, we'll reach out to them, and that knowledge helps us to remedy these situations. Historical background. If we've had these type of incidents before, we do a historical search. That's the nice thing about having incident databases. And then sometimes we have to call in experts. You know, if we have a process failure, you know, we'll call in somebody that understands that equipment a lot better than we do, and they'll give us that information, you know, in order for us to make this situation better. So what does a good investigation do? Well, it does four things for us. It develops sound corrective actions, making sure we have corrective actions put into place to prevent this from happening again. It identifies hazards in similar conditions. Maybe we have this where it's going to happen in all our facilities. Maybe something that happens in the quarry can happen into the asphalt plants. Something in construction can maybe happen in asphalt. I mean, those are the type of things that we take a look at. It guides our policies and procedures. You know, a couple of months back, just now, you know, we had a haul truck roll over. So we identified that we needed to strengthen up our stockpile procedure. So we put a team together. They're just finishing it off now, and we'll be sharing it with everybody. So it guides our policy and procedures, and it dispels misunderstandings. You know, we're just like any other organization. We have a little gossip trail. You know, somebody hears something here, somebody tells it here, somebody, you know, conveys a message here, and sometimes that information may not be correct. So we want to make sure that we dispel those misunderstandings. Everybody's just getting the facts of what happened and making sure that they feel comfortable with the corrective actions that we've put into place. So in this safety professional's mind, when we have incidents, that means we've had a breakdown in our management system somehow. So earlier this year, we put a safety management system into play, you know, management commitment, employee engagement, maintenance of safe, environmentally sound working conditions, you know, our training and development, all of that is a management system that we all live by. And that's how Tilcon New York rolls, okay? We roll all together with regards under that management system. So we have incidents, somehow there was some kind of breakdown in that management system that we have to correct in order to make sure it doesn't happen. So we have, you know, the whole thing for us is fact-finding and not fault-finding. We do not want to point the finger at anybody. We do not want to blame anybody with regards to the incidents. We just want to find the facts. So the whole thing with all of this is just to prevent the reoccurrence. We want to make sure it doesn't happen again. Doesn't happen again for us, doesn't happen again for you, it doesn't happen, you know, we share that information as well. One of the things that we're doing now, we just set up a folder in our SharePoint under the Tilcon New York SharePoint, and what ended up, what we're doing is we're going to be dropping all the events learnings. We're taking the names off to protect, you know, protect the innocent, if you will, but we're going to be dropping all those events learnings into that file folder that your supervisors and managers will be able to share with all of you to make sure that they, you know, that we can spread the word with regards to these incidents. So, I think that's it for that. So, a couple of minor things I want to talk about. You know, as we have an uptick with regards to the COVID-19, you know, I know our CEO of the organization put out something on mental health awareness. Just a couple of things is that, you know, a lot of people are dealing with loneliness. You know, people that have not gone out during the event. This is my 30th video. And before that, I had 2 weeks where I put out a weekly safety message. So we're going into the 33rd week of COVID-19. That's a long time. Some people have not left the house. Some people have groceries delivered. So a lot of people are dealing with loneliness. Domestic violence is up. Suicides are up. You know, people are just not being able to deal with it. So please, by all means, we still have an employee assistance program. If you or a loved one or a family member or, you know, a friend, you know, please let them reach out to this service. It's there for you. And the other thing is, you know, like Allstate, be a good neighbor. You know, check on your neighbors. If you feel somebody, you haven't seen somebody in a while, you know, either you check or maybe contact the police and let them go check. The other thing is that we've starting a couple of weeks ago, we put in a new contractor pre-qualification process. And that's really to strengthen up our process in order to bring contractors to work for us on our facilities. We want to make sure we're bringing contractors that have the same safety philosophies that we do. That's important. And then the last thing I want to talk about is that, and I'm really proud of this, is that we invited 11 shop stewards from the different unions throughout the organization to form a safety leadership steering committee. And our first meeting is this Wednesday coming up. And I'm really proud that the guys agreed to do this. And it's gonna give us an opportunity to make our safety process better. Working together, united, as a united front, to see what's going on at the locations, what we need to make changes on. So with that in mind, Tilcon New York, have a safe week, enjoy, and take care.